Boom, here we are at the Flying Can Ranch. Hey, I did a video a while back and I had tried a scope on one of my newer air guns. I really had horrible results with it. So I kind of talk bad about it, but I want to show you something here. I'm going to set this down. We're going to focus on these three cans. Hopefully I can get a good shot. I've got everything loaded up, ready to go. Let's rock and roll. All right, just for fun, we'll set them up, give one more run. I'm still having a problem with this one right there. I don't know what it is. Oh, I skidded right across the top of it. That one wasn't where I wanted it either. So, give me a chance here. It's work in progress. to get with it without boring you to death. We'll wind this back a little bit. I don't know if I got this one right down at the bottom, I think it was. Let me see where my mark is. Yeah, a little upward, right about there. So I've got to do a little adjustment. And I caught this one right on the edge, same way. So I'm going to have to bring it back to the right some. Set that back down where it might stay. And you can see where I took this guy several times. Same thing, kind of the right, because I'm shooting off that line topside. So let's go over here real quick and explain what I got going. Hopefully the video, my video dried out on me the last time. I realized I had too much stuff on my phone to get away with it. Everybody laying there. So what I did is basically I took this scope and I worked it over and I put it on this, I dropped it down on top of this Ruger AirHawk Elite 2. So that's what I got it sitting on, right there it is. And I think the big problem was this parallax adjustment up here. Once I got that dialed in, I did pretty good. So this is the actual box that the scope came in. So you see what that is. I'm not too sure if this is designed for this kind of vibration. I'm going to tell you why I think I had a big problem using this in the first place is I noticed the gaps on these are pretty wide along here on this Weaver. And when I mounted it, I was going from an 11 millimeter down here to a Weaver type. So I had a conversion rail I was using, and I think the conversion rail was jacking the scope up a little bit. So that may have been what caused the problem. Like I said, I tried this on about three other guns, and it just kept hitting low, kept hitting low, kept hitting low. And I said, something's got to be jacking this up. So I moved it over to this guy. I was mainly using JSBs. I don't have the can adder with me right now to try this out. But you got a little illumination dial back here. You can change it different colors and different dimensions. But it seems to work good on this rifle. I'm hoping that it'll hold up good with the vibration of it. So I just wanted to share that with y'all that I did finally find something that it would work on, and it seems to be working. Yeah, this is not a quiet neighborhood, by the way. That it's working, it's hitting pretty accurate. Like I said, I might have to grind it back to the left just a little bit, but I've got it to work. So with this type of mount that came on the gun, it's already on the gun, it mounted up really well, and it seemed to sink down and get a good bite. And I was noticing on this, it just, I don't know, maybe it just wasn't biting in. Maybe the actual bolts that go across weren't really mating into here real well. I'm not sure. I've used these before on some red dots. I've showed this to you in the past. So at any rate, just want to share that with you. I've got a weight bar waiting over there for me. I got to start out real slow. I haven't done anything for some time, and I'm really ashamed of myself for that. I'm getting really bad shape, so I'm going to get back on that today. And I get crazy with some deadlifts, but, you know, try to get myself getting back in the swing of it. I did some bench presses and some shoulder works previous weekends. I meant to do something yesterday, but, you know, something else came up. And get that done, and maybe I'm just going to go for a little ride. It's really crisp out here this morning. It felt, you know, cold. It was great getting out of this heat. So I hope you all have a blessed day. And another thing I want to say is, I really thank you, all you viewers, for subscribing, and I've had comments from Spain, I've had comments from Russia, I've had comments from England. I never expected it to get like that, but I really enjoyed it all, and I thank you all for supporting me and watching my channel. So, moving right along. Again, I hope you all have a good day and everything works out good for you. And that's how we do it at the Flying Can Ranch. We will talk to you all later. I got a new toy I'm thinking about bringing in starting Monday. So pay attention. We'll see if I can get it. Later.